Hello everybody and thank you all for watching again. This is a new episode of How to DIY RC and today we are reviewing the Rankem MicroSwift and the ETX O3 from eScene sent to me by Banggood to review. So I want to thank them all and I put the links down below in the description. We're going to do a comparison versus the normal Swift 1 and the standard CMOS all-in-one FPV camera system that we are using on our mini drones at the moment. Before we are going to show you the video comparison, we want to go into over the features of the MicroSwift, going over the size and the weight and of the combo together, of course. And you can already see it's almost as small as the CMOS FPV camera. Still a little bit bigger, but they are already getting there. To compare to the MicroSwift we are probably already using on our planes and micro drones, that's almost half in size and height. Almost have in the same in height because the lens is a lot smaller, a lot less height. And that's the size. And let's go for the weight. Let's first check the normal Rankem Swift. It comes up at 12 to 13 grams. And then put on the Rankem Micro Swift. It comes up at 6 grams. And then with the combination, it's only 9 grams. So that's still a lot lighter than the Micro Swift. But only the MicroSwift Rankem is already half the weight of a normal Swift. But of course, it's still not there, as this is only 4 grams all-in-one FPV system. And this was 9 grams. So it still needs to save off 5 grams, Rankem. Do your best. I want to see a 3.3 grams CCD camera. I hope that is a good tip. And you never know, Rankem is bringing out new cameras every week. They are doing really good and you can never go wrong with Rankem. The quality is so better than this little CMOS cameras. But let's get over what we get in the box with the combination of the Rankem MicroSwift and the AX03. And it comes really in a really tiny box compared to the MicroSwift box. You can fit almost 6 of them inside of a normal Rankem Swift box. So save them a lot of money on shipping. But going over the features of the MicroSwift, you can see it's running from 5 volts all the way up to 36 volts. And that's meaning that you can run it from a 2 cell to an 8 cell. This is amazing. You can even use it for your long range FPV planes if you want to use it. But I'm guessing you're still going to probably use the normal Swift. And it comes with a 2.1 millimeter lens. That's also a lot shorter than the normal Swift. The normal Swift comes with a 2.8 lens. And the voltage is from 5 to 17 volts. So the micro Swift can do a lot more, all the way up to 36. But 5 volts, the combination, the ETX, I call it the VTX because it's a video transmitter, that runs from 3.2 all the way up to 5.5 volts. So that's not a lot. With the box you also get a mount so you can easily mount your Rankem. It's a metal mount so it makes it super easy, and a few screws to hold it down. It's really nice of them, making it super easy for you to mount it on your planes or mini drones. And you get two cables. They are exactly 3-pin cables, they are exactly the same except for the length. One is a little bit longer than the other one. The one thing that you're missing in the box is, because this is the programming cable that you can use to change out all the settings. But I must say the stock settings of the Micro Rankem are perfect for daylight flying. So I'm not complaining if you're not getting the cable. You don't really need it. Let's move it all out of the way and go over the combination of the ATX eScene ATX O3 VTX transmitter. Because most people, when the Rankem MicroSwift came out, asked for a combination of an all-in-one FPV camera like this one. And that's why they are now selling this combination for a few bucks more. You can straight on have a good VTX and camera, super light for your mini drones. And this Micro VTX runs on 72 channels, and I got a 25, 50 and 200 milliwatt video output. can handle a lot of range for such a lady, tiny micro VTX that is also super light and also the drums therefore super hot. And it comes with a flexible whip antenna. I like it, but there are less chance of breaking off. And if they break off, this one probably won't break off, they will just click off. And if you can refine it in the high grass, wherever you're flying, you can just click it back on. And if you have a few spares around, it's super easily just change them out if you lose one. But I would gladly put a piece of hot glue on that, just to make sure you don't lose it in the first crash. We are just having a tiny issue with this combination, and that is that the stock cable is a 4-pin. It also has an option for audio recording, transmitting. And the Runcam Micro Swift only comes with a 3-pin connector. The other is a 2-pin connector, that is for the program cable, for the changing the features of the camera. But luckily, the Runcam Micro Swift came with two cables. They are both the same, so you have 4 3-pin cables. So you can change out the cable, just flipping those up and pulling out the cable. Just change out the connector, or you just cut the wires and resolder the wires and leave out the white one, because the white one is for audio. You just need the yellow, red and black. But this is just a simple fix that we are going to do off camera, and then we will come back to you and show you the footage. And this is the end of the Runcam Micro Swift review comparison versus the normal Swift and the all-in-one FPV CMOS camera. Next weekend we'll be doing a test flight, so subscribe. And sincerely, I hope you like this video and check out the links down below. And I want to wish you happy flying and goodbye. Until next time.